It's a couple Jordan 1 retros and they gotta be in your collection. You just collect them, you never go stepping. I can respect it, but that ain't for me. I gotta lace up these black cement threes and throw a little fit together. Get on the go, out, place a bid, and hopefully I can just hit forever. I'm from the bottom, a little one arrive, but it's part of our culture, you gotta be proud. Where I'm flying with the Air Forces, put that shit on to the day that I die. Nikes over Adidas.
What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, the Retro Wiz Kid, the Shoeologist. And y'all rocking with your boy in the Sneaker Dungeon, y'all. Hope everyone's having a great day. Today, y'all, we are going to be taking a look at a sneaker that I've actually had for a while. I ain't even going to cap, y'all. I got these when they released on Reebok.com. The night, man, I was like, yo, I didn't even think I was going to hit. Because I was thinking about trying to pick them up locally. But I was just like, man, I ain't going to waste it. I'm just go for them at midnight. Maybe people might be sleeping. And, of course, I was able to hit, as you guys see. And shout out to Reebok, man. They get a best military discount than anybody else, man. These, the suggested retail was $140. I paid $101 with tax for this sneaker to be shipped. You can't beat that, man. You really can't beat it, man. You cannot. So shout out to Reebok for the superb discount. You feel me? Now, if you guys are new to the channel, before we get all the way into this full detail review and on feet, y'all make sure y'all hit that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. Join your boy, the Retro Wiz Kid, and the Sneaker Dungeon family. All the love and support is greatly appreciated and is not going unnoticed. Let's try to get this video right here up to 100 likes, y'all. Smash the like button for your boy. It helps take the channel a lot further. Head over to Instagram. Follow your boy at the Retro Wiz Kid. We are on the race to 10,000 followers over on Instagram. I do post daily on that thing, man. And if I miss a day, best believe I'm a double bag and they gonna keep coming. But anyway, y'all, with all that being said, let's get into these sneakers, y'all. Right here we have that standard Allen Iverson box that we're used to seeing. I know when I got my LA pair, they were in like that blue and red box, which I had never seen a pair of Iversons come in a box like that. Now, the official name and colorway of this sneaker is the Question Mid, size 11, black. I don't really know what FTW white supposed to stand for, but it's FTW white. That's what it means. I really don't know what the FTW stand for, but I know that the WHT, that's white. And these are a size 11. And the suggested retail on these was $140, y'all. And we in there. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, y'all. We have. Some people would call these, you know what I'm saying, kind of like the Concord type vibe of an Allen Iverson Question Mid. In my eyes, this is one of the best mids to ever release. You know, I had a pair that was very similar to this growing up when I was playing for Atlanta Hawk basketball camp. Man, I had a pair that looked a lot like this, just slightly different. And I told you guys, when they dropped that black toe, man, I gotta get them. Now, on this pair right here, you do have a nice smoke gray type effect on the bottom of the sole right there. I love how they did that. A nice white midsole with the upper coming in this nice leather. And when I say nice leather, man, y'all know it ain't no crazy, but it's nice. You know what I'm saying? It is a very nice leather for them to put on this Question Mid. I think they did a great job, outstanding job. Look, when you're looking at that toe, man, just bouncing on it right there, you guys can see the black leather is nice and it's soft and it just goes in and bounces right back up. Now, a little history about this sneaker and how this whole sneaker came to play. Back in 2001, Allen Iverson and his Eastern Conference teammates secured a narrow 111-110 victory in the NBA All-Star game after being down as much as 19 points. At the end of the third quarter, the answer was crowned the All-Star game MVP for his impressive 25-point performance. In celebration of this year's NBA All-Star festivities, Reebok releasing this sneaker to pay homage. Now, as for why these are being crowned the Why Nots, Iverson told the media at the post-game press conference following the 01 All-Star game that everybody was saying we couldn't win because of our size. It's about the size of your heart. Coming into the fourth quarter, we were all sitting on the sideline saying, why not us? Why not us? Why not be able to catch this dub? You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie, man. All-Star games ain't been like that to me ever since, like, back in the day when they used to all wear their different jerseys to represent their teams. Now, you know, you got team this versus team this, and then they all wearing the same junk. It's just not the same, man. I definitely say that. But Really, really fire. You got that Why Not Us behind the tongue on the sneaker. Really fuego, man. I'm going to throw these bad boys on feet for y'all real quick just so y'all can see what these things are looking like. We ain't going to do too many jeans. Probably just throw some cargos on for you guys, because when it comes to this sneaker being bulky, I like to rock like the cargo type vibe with them, or either rock like some pants that got the drawstrings where it's kind of like a puff sitting on top of the sneaker. But y'all let me know what you guys think about these things. We're going to throw these bad boys on feet real quick, and we're going to wrap this thing up. Yeti!
I'ma leave it where it be. Leave that for a week and now I hear you for the streets. I ain't telling rumors, I'm just asking this for me. Used to ride the bus, but now you riding around for free. Sneaky link so much it made you sneakier than me.
Right.
Bought this girl jersey since she always round the team.
Right.
Brought you over early at the six, you gotta leave. I ain't telling rumors, I'm just telling what I seen. Sneaky link so much it made you sneakier than me. Like we on the bus, you find me posted in the back bay. No seat belts while we drive, but we strapped back.
Right.
Swerving off the drink, feel the lean on the slacks.
Right.
Lamborghini dreams, what you think? This a rat race. Your friends always loud up in the background. Don't know how to act, you cutting up for the snap now. Used to call you up and lay the smack down. Used to wake you up to smoke and fucking lay you back down.
Right.
Hey, big checks, baby, no sweat. I want more checks for more sex. You want more wet? I want more wet. Leave out for a week and now I hear you for the streets. I ain't telling rumors, I'm just asking this for me. Used to ride the bus, but now you riding around for free. Sneaky link so much it made you sneakier than me.
Right.
Bought this girl jersey since she always round the team.
Right. I hope you guys enjoyed the full detailed review over the Why Not Us questions, man. Super fuego, man. It was a must cop, man. This was a must cop for your boy, man. And seeing that it looks so close to the sneaker that I played ball in when I was playing for the Atlanta Hawks basketball camp, man, shout out to my cuzzo AI, man. He definitely delivered, and I'm glad that they bought this signature colorway back, man. You know, just nostalgia. And it's a fire sneaker, y'all. So now y'all see, man, we've been moving, man. I think last year we picked up two questions. This year we picked up two questions. This is my second pickup of a question this year. You know what I'm saying? I picked up the question low oatmeals last year, and we got the LA joints this year, and we got this one right here. So super fire, man. Let me know what you guys think about these bad boys, man. Stay tuned to the channel. Got a lot of heat coming, man. Got a lot of bangers coming for y'all. Switching it up, man. It's been a lot harder to get sneakers this year. I would definitely say that, man. We ain't getting certain shoes. We ain't get the Stealth 5s. You know what I'm saying? I didn't get the Stealth 5s. I didn't hit on those on the FLX app and all that good stuff. And some of the spots didn't even have them. But I told myself, I'm not paying. At the time, they were going for like $300. I was like, I'm not dropping $300 on those, man. I'll go spend $300 and cop something else. And that's exactly what your boy did. And I didn't even have to pay $300. But y'all already know what it is, man. I will spin the pictures for you guys. Stay tuned to the channel. Until the next video, peace, love, in Laguna Beach. And we out this thing. Yeti!
It's a couple Jordan 1 retros, and they gotta be in your collection. You just collect them, you never gon' step in. I can respect it, but that ain't for me. I gotta lace up these blessed in threes and throw a little fit together. Get on the go, L, place a bid, and hopefully I can just hit forever. I'm from the bottom, a little one around, but it's part of our culture, you gotta be proud. Where I'm flowing with the Air Forces, put that shit on to the day that I die. Nikes over Adidas, get stressed and I don't even try. Take all my Jordans and Forces away from me and watch a young nigga steal. Alexander McQueen.